I came across a rather interesting text the other day by an intelligent chap called Joseph Priestley. A key phrase I took a liking to was the greatest happiness to the greatest number. Yes, I believe that was a great phrase to base an idea upon. So, that's what I did. The principle of utility aims to promote happiness, which is the supreme ethical value. By adding up the amounts of pleasure and pain for each possible act, we should be able to choose the right thing to do in any situation. With this in mind, I provided a way of measuring this, called the hedonic calculus, which has 7 simple elements involved. How deep the pleasure. How long it lasts. How near or far the pleasure will occur in time. How permanent the pleasure is. How secure you are to think there will be pleasure, and how universal the pleasure is. Basically, if more people are feeling pleasure than not, you did the right thing, because that pleasure can be measured quantitatively.
In some aspects, I agree with Jeremy. However, some parts of what he said are just a bit daft if you ask me.
Fuck you!
If you take the Christians and the Romans, for example, lots of Romans would take great pleasure in seeing Christians be eaten by a big-ass lion.
But that doesn't make it morally right.
In fact, if you measure the intensity and quality of the Romans' pleasure to the intensity of pain in the small group of Christians, it will outweigh the pleasure of the greatest number. This proves the situation morally wrong. Not to mention how certain pleasures are quite simply animalistic. And therefore, obviously, cannot be rated as highly as the pleasure brought by doing something intellectual, like reading a poem, for example. It is clearly a better use of my time to gain pleasure from a piece of literature or music than from eating or something vulgar like sex. I should not behave like a lower class creation, barbaric, to gain pleasure, as that pleasure will never compare to that of using my mind. Something that no animal can quite do the same as a human. Pleasures such as a quickie in the back of your car will never be of as great quality as an intellectual pleasure. It is timeless.
Fuck you!
How deep the pleasure.